Okay, now you see this video, tak tahulah betul tak betul, tapi very possible lah. I've heard the story before. Bila dah ramai, Rohingya dah ramai, mereka start demanding lah. Selayang ni, mereka kata dia punya hak, dia punya argument dia, pasal dia dah contribute to the nation, and therefore, dia patut ada sama rata, hak sama rata. So, sekarang ni, very interesting kan, reminiscent pula, macam orang India, China pun minta equality kan, yang mana tu kan.
Klaim sudah menyumbang pada ekonomi, pengungsi Rohingya minta hak tanah di Selayang, Selangor, Malaysia. Seorang pria yang berasal dari etnis Rohingya di Malaysia menuntut hak yang setara dengan warga setempat dengan klaim bahwa mereka juga berkontribusi pada ekonomi negara. Pria tersebut dengan tegas meminta pemerintah Malaysia memberikan daerah Selayang di Selangor kepada Rohingya. Ia menganggapnya sebagai hak mereka yang tak boleh dicampuri oleh bangsa lain. Sekarang kerajaan Malaysia mesti beri hak sama rata kepada kami, kaum minoriti, kaum pelarian, bangsa Rohingya, katanya. Kami sudah menyumbang kepada ekonomi negara. Sekarang kami mau menuntut hak. Kami juga manusia. Beri kami Selayang pun sudah cukup. Beri kami Selayang, lanjutnya. Selayang tempat tinggal Rohingya, orang Melayu, jangan kacau. Selayang kawasan kami, kata lelaki tersebut. Tambahnya lagi, Selayang adalah hak mereka dan tidak boleh dikacau. Cina, Melayu, India, atau Indonesia tidak boleh kacau. Tidak boleh masuk, jangan coba kacau, ini kawasan kami, katanya lagi. Diketahui ada 200 ribu pengungsi Rohingya di Malaysia saat ini.
Now, tetapi apa pun, perlembagaan is perlembagaan lah, termaktuklah perlembagaan. There's no such thing as equality of race pun. Tapi orang minta lah. So there's no nothing wrong in minta. Tapi kalau nak buat threaten lah, tak boleh masuk, orang tak boleh masuk sini, orang tak boleh masuk sana. Even the non-Malays don't do that. The Cina dengan India, dengan bangsa lain pun tak buat macam tu, kata, oh kepung jinjang tempat Cina, Melayu tak boleh masuk. Aku makan tak berhenti sana, kawan aku ramai sana. India, breakfast, only India place. I go to breakfast all the time. I makan there. So what? I also go there and tak ada siapa tahan siapa pun. Kampung baru orang tak kata ini tempat Melayu, orang Cina tak datang. Tak ada banyak orang Cina, Melayu, India pun pergi kampung baru makan nasi lemak, semua tu.
Before we start, if you haven't already, please consider subscribing and ringing the bell to stay in the loop and be notified when we release new videos.
Semua tu. Jadi, kita semua live harmoniously. There will be people who are insisting on equality, even rakyat Malaysia. Tapi perlembagaan still terguna pakai. No government is going to go and change that and unravel the constitution. That is not going to happen. Now, masuk Rohingya who not even Malaysians, now they come, they want to claim because they say they contributed. They help bina negara. Now, first things first, we cannot deny that they came and banyak bangunan nenek-nenek semua tu, bangla, Rohingya semua tu lah. They came in, kenapa? Kita buat masuk dia orang. Bukan dia masuk suka hati dia. Immigration allows and therefore some of them get work permit. Why is that so? So firstly, kita tak boleh marah sangat non-Malaysians masuk, foreigners masuk, labour. Kita kata dia berbising lah, menyemak lah, marah kat airport semua. They came in kenapa? Pasal orang perlu. Kita tak cukup tenaga kerja to do all kinds of things. Jadi kita perlu dia to tolong kita make economy. So therefore, first things first, nak cross out this one first. Firstly, nak underscore, bukan cross out, underscore this. They did contribute to our economy and they continue to contribute to our economy. We require them. Okay, tetapi it is only fair, jangan tengok only from one lens lah, from the other lens. Why are they contributing to our economy? They did not contribute to our economy in order to be able to cause Selayang in my place. They came here for better living. They came here because there's better income than staying in their country. Kat negara dia orang macam Rohingya tu, dia kena slaughter. So they come here for a better life. And when they stay here, dia punya rumah, dia punya anak-anak pergi sekolah, dia punya pakaian dia, whatever dia punya lifestyle is, dia dapat duit tu daripada mana? Daripada Malaysia juga kan? daripada employers in Malaysia kan, daripada kerajaan juga kan. So jadi sekarang ni, we must also contend that kita pun contribute kepada ekonomi diorang, ekonomi keluarga diorang. So therefore they are where they are today, they are where they are dengan bongkaknya, dengan bangganya nak claim Selayang tu dia punya. They are even there at Selayang based on the ehsan of Malaysia. It is an exchange. They did not come to this country to contribute and to build the country for free. And now, because we've done this for you, Selayang should be ours. No. They came in, they got paid. We paid them. They took money in exchange and they were happy to continue. And why do they want to stay in Selayang? Why they want to remain here when they are not from Selayang? Because they like to continue this arrangement because it is beneficial to them. Because it is helping their economy. Bukan ekonomi negara, tapi ekonomi diri dia, dia orang sendiri. So therefore, they should not be laungkan, dia tolong ekonomi kita. No, it's an exchange. It's a business arrangement. It is a commercial arrangement. And commercial arrangement is that you come and you got to, of course, reside somewhere. You kena ada rumah you, you sewa ke, squatters ke, wherever. You akan kena tempat untuk you punya business dan you punya services. Barang-barang you nak jual ke apa ke. There must be a place for you. We desire that. It's good for our economy. It's also good for your economy. It's a symbiotic, it's a synergetic arrangement antara kita dengan all those people. Notwithstanding, ada juga yang macam Rohingya kapal sini datang because of simpati. Ehsan, kita bantu. Yang tu kalau macam tu still nak demand, yang tu lagi teruk lah. Tapi in the case of Rohingya ni, we acknowledge dia banyak, banyak je contribution dia. Dia contribute, bukan dia saja. Bangla pun so contribute. Nepalis pun contribute. Indonesian pun contribute. Vietnamese, ramai. There's so many that's here. Orang from India, orang from China pun ada buat kerja juga kat sini. So, Vietnam. Jadi, we welcome people who come here. We welcome people who does and contribute towards the economy. But remember, when you say contribute to an economy, you don't contribute for free. You contribute in exchange for money. You get paid to come in. We pay people to come in. Likewise, if I go to Singapore to work or whatever, and I go there and I because it's better money for me. So can I say I build Singapore and therefore what? Jurong tu aku punya. Come on lah. You cannot go and to other people's country and because you work there, you contribute there, you do business with them, therefore tempat tu dia you punya. So if I go to a particular restaurant, hari-hari aku makan. Aku bawa kawan-kawan semua aku makan kat meja besar tu. And all my meals I eat there. And because of that, the restaurant pun besar-besar, kembang-kembang. Restaurant tu pun ada orang lain juga yang apa ni, yang makan situ kan. Tapi because I spend so much money, beribu-ribu sebulan makan kat situ. Can I now go to the restaurant and say, claim this table ni aku punya. Nobody can sit here. Reserve this for me and orang lain jangan masuk restaurant ni. Boleh? So tak boleh lah. You can apa ni, that what kind of a warp logic is that? Jadi siapa-siapa yang pandai-pandai nak claim kata ini dia main tempat, do whatever, we should not tolerate, dia boleh cakap lah apa nak cakap pun. Cakap je. Tapi if they act on it, they start stopping people from coming Selayang, they start to be violent or insisting their right that is not provided under the law, then action should be taken on them. Kalau ada report, police should take action and they need to be deported. Send back. Tak payah. Then don't come and build Selayang anymore. Kalau you rasa you kuat sangat, kita ada undang-undang. Kita ada polis. Kita ada immigration. And you come here to build. Memang you betul. You come here to build the economy. You did not come here to destroy the economy or to create ruckus ataupun anarchy ataupun be a nuisance in this country. If you are, then you should leave the country. We should treat all foreigners that way. If they are here to create nuisance, they should not be in this country. I don't think any Malaysian will disagree with me on this point.
If you enjoy our insights, please consider subscribing to help us bring more content like this. Thank you for tuning in. Clicking the subscribe button is a great motivation for the channel. Thank you very much.